Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Johanna, and for those of you who are new here, welcome. And for those of you who are returning, welcome back. In today's video, I want to give you some information about my journey towards monetization, as well as what a small YouTuber can make on the platform. And if that is of interest to you, please stay tuned. Okay, so in the pinned comment, as well as in the description box, I will have this time stamped on the various sections that I will be talking about. So if you're only interested in the actual income that I've made for September 2020, paid in October 2020, then just go ahead and skip to that. Now, I want to put a few disclaimers on this video. I generally do not do face forward videos. The majority of my content are top down content, and I usually do that at home. I'm in the office today during my lunch break, and so what you would normally see in these kind of videos is a really cool backdrop and great lighting and all of that. Well, I don't have that, and honestly, I don't need that for the type of niche market that I'm in. So if you hear office noises, that's why. But I do want to just point that out, that that's generally not something that you're going to see in these kinds of videos. I also have my notes under here. I'm not scripting this. I'm just sort of talking to you from one small content creator to another. But I did want to have sort of an outline of where I wanted this video to go. Now, my numbers may not coordinate with your numbers depending on your niche market, your views, your RPM, your CPM, and all those things, and I will talk about that in just a little bit. So this is really just to give you an idea of what it could be if you are in the YouTube Partner Program, if you are in a small niche market, and if your numbers and views are similar to mine. Again, it's not supposed to be this is what it will be. It's just what it could be. But it is a perspective that I haven't seen a lot of here on the platform. Now, I will be ending this video showing you sort of a full circle perspective of what my numbers were and how I will be budgeting those numbers, but I am not a budget channel. So if you are interested in some really good budget channels that I watch, I'll link them below. And those channels include Budgeting D, Aaron of Oh My Goals, Lushan of Lushan's Lifestyle, and Mo from Better Late Than Broke, but also includes Nicole of Nicole Lorraine Plans. Now, she's a planner channel. However, she does have a series where she is working towards monetization, and so she is budgeting revenue that she is receiving from side projects, hustles, and expenses accordingly. Now, as a small channel here on YouTube, I am in a highly niched market. So the market that I consider myself in and the community that I consider myself a part of is planners, journals, and paper crafting for the most part. Now, even within that niche, I am even more specialized in that the way that I generally do my videos is different from what you would see in the mainstream, if there is such a thing, planner channels or journal channels in this niche market. So that could affect the numbers that I have. So if you are in the same niche market and you do generally top-down videos, then just know my numbers could be more or less depending on the way that I am doing things. And because I don't really have anyone else to compare to, I can only give you the numbers that I have. As of today, which is November 24th, 2020, I do have 3,517 subscribers. So thank you to all of you who are following me on this journey. Now, if you're interested in more content regarding my thoughts as a content creator in a specialized niche market, then definitely let me know in the comments below. Now, how do you qualify to be monetized? Now, whether you are a small YouTube channel or thinking about creating a small YouTube channel, the two things you need to remember is you do need to have at least 1,000 subscribers on your YouTube channel, as well as 4,000 watch hours. Now that's important to note because most of the metrics that they give you on your dashboard is watch minutes. Now it's easy enough to convert. However, I'm not sure when they changed it, but I do have a second channel here on YouTube, and I noticed when I had started that channel that they actually have the monetization tab, and it clearly defines where you are in your own journey. So I'll go ahead and put up a screenshot of that now. Now, clearly, I definitely have a long way to go to get to monetization on that channel. Now, I do love that they have put in very clear terms where you are as of right now and where you need to work towards in order to get to the monetization goal. Now, please note, as of November 18th, 2020, YouTube did update their terms of service to say that they can monetize any video. Now, what that means is any video on their platform, they can put ads in the front, the middle, or the end of the video. And they have the absolute right to do that. Now, although YouTube has included that update in their terms of service, I haven't noticed any changes to some of the smaller channels that I watch. So I don't know if that's just something they plan to roll out more, if they're going to be targeting videos that are doing well but are not monetized. I'm not sure how they will be doing that, but that is something that has been updated as of November 18th, 2020. Now, if you are interested in the importance of engagement in regards to your own YouTube journey, let me know in the comments below. Now, because one of the metrics in order to become monetized is having at least 1,000 subscribers, I think there is a conception or a misconception that the more subscribers you have, the better your channel will do by way of monetization. Ultimately, monetization is based on views. Having a large subscriber count can help your channel. That does give you a focused market on people who've already decided that they like your content, they like you, they like whatever it is that you're putting out there, so they have already subscribed. And if they have checked on the notify all, then anytime you upload content, they will be notified. So you sort of have this captured market. However, views is where the monetization actually is. So in order to determine how much money that you can potentially make, you would look at the number of views times your RPM, and that would give you your potential estimated income. Subscriber counts only help you if people are watching your videos. You could have tons of subscribers, but if no one's watching, then it doesn't matter because you don't have an increase in views. Conversely, you could have a small subscriber count, so long as you have at least 1,000. And so long as they are watching your videos, then you could actually be earning income versus someone who has tons of subscribers but not having as many views. Now, if you are interested in more information on subscribers versus views and my perspective from a small channel in a niche market, then definitely leave me a comment below. Now, I've mentioned a couple of times now RPM versus CPM. Now, for the longest time, CPM was the only metric that YouTube would provide you in the analytics. And CPM is cost per mille. And mille is just a fancy word for 1,000. So for every 1,000 views, the CPM would give you the cost of what the advertisers would be paying in your market towards your channel. Now again, CPM, RPM can vary wildly depending on where you live, who your demographic is, what your niche market is. And so there is no gold standard of, well, it's always going to be this, because it can range from very little to a lot depending on the type of content that you are creating. Now, as of July 2020, YouTube did update content creators analytics to also include RPM, which is revenue per mille. So that shows the revenue of your channel specifically to your metrics. And so I would advise you that if you are monetized, to look at that number, not so much the CPM. And the reason why there can be a variance between those two numbers is if you are monetized, whatever income is generated on your channel, which is a CPM, that doesn't include what YouTube takes out. It just includes the broad overview of how much your channel has earned per 1,000 views. You get to keep, as a content creator, 55% of that income. YouTube keeps 45%. So if you really want to get an idea of what your estimated income is, you would take the number of views that you have, times it by the RPM listed on your channel for your niche and your demographics and all of that, and that should give you your estimated income on a month-to-month basis. Now, they are constantly updating that information. Now, on the YouTube Studio on the PC and laptop, I don't know that I've seen it on the app on my phone. It does show you actually a breakdown, and you can change up the preferences to show the last 28 days, the last month overall, and get a idea of where your RPM is on any given basis. Again, the longer you are monetized, the more data that you'd have available at your fingertips. Now, if you are interested in more on RPMs and CPMs in a niche market, again, leave me a comment in the comment section below. All right, so we are finally at the point where I'm going to show you some of my stats. Now, some stats, according to my research, are just not shareable or shouldn't be shared. Now, I've seen this information on YouTube, so please take that with a grain of salt. But when I reached out to those in the YouTube forum asking specifically, can I share my RPM and my CPM numbers? I was told, based on the terms of service, that information is considered private. Now, it's not even that I want this video to be demonetized. It's more, I don't want my channel to be demonetized, and I don't know if breaking that terms of service would do that. So I won't show you my specific screen on my RPM and my CPM, but I will insert a picture now of what my numbers were. It is based off a date range of September 1st through September 30th, 2020. There is a month lag, and so I was paid for those numbers on October 21st, 2020. Now, for more information regarding thresholds and your specific country, because that actually makes a difference, I will link down in the description box below the page where you can find that information. So this is just information as it pertains to me. Now, as you can see on the screen, in September, I had a little over 12,000 views. My watch time hours was 1,900. I increased by 100 subscribers, and my, what it says is, my estimated revenue was $111.61, was actually my revenue per Google AdSense, as well as the direct deposit that hit the account. That's actually what it was. And so while it's not a huge earth-shattering number, I'm very thankful for the revenue that I am generating on this account. Now, if you look at the number of videos that I uploaded just in total, as well as what I uploaded in September, I could actually get a part-time job and make a lot more. But my goal and my focus on my YouTube channel is just to share my interest and my creativity. And if I can earn some additional money on the side, that's fabulous. But first and foremost, I am more interested in just sharing my journey and sharing my creativity on the YouTube platform. Now, to finish out the video, I'm going to show you how I budgeted those numbers. Now, something that I should have mentioned back when I was talking about monetization is, if you are in your own YouTube journey towards monetization, I would actually highly encourage you to sign up for your Google AdSense account now. It is better, in my opinion, to have that waiting for you to be monetized than for you to become eligible for monetization and then you have to wait for all of the Google AdSense things to sync up, because that could take a couple of weeks, that could take a couple of months. Now, I can't show you how to go through that. There are tons of videos here on the platform that you can search for that for, but just know if you are working towards monetization and you have not signed up for Google AdSense yet, I highly recommend that you do that. Now, getting into the actual budget, I have done a screenshot here of that. Generally, I would actually do a top-down video, but I didn't have that prepared, so I just did something in Canva.com just to show you my numbers. As you can see, for YouTube AdSense revenue, I did make $111.61. I do have a blog, jojozahanna.com, and I have Google Ads running on there as well, and I made $8.21. From the actual WordPress site that hosts my blog, I have made $0 in the last 2 years, so yay. For Amazon affiliate, I've made $0, and my Etsy shop is currently on vacation. So for the month of September, I made $0. So the amount that I am using to budget is $119.82, and that was what was deposited into my account. Now the expenses that I am using that revenue for is I did earmark 30% of the overall amount to go towards taxes. YouTube does not take out taxes for you, so that is something that you need to be aware of. I do have fees that come out of this account that the direct deposit hits, and so for Canva.com, I do pay $12.95 every month, and that is the PC laptop fee. I actually pay a separate fee for my personal account for the pro version of Canva on my phone. Yeah, I also pay $10.45 for Intuit QuickBooks every month, and that comes out of that account. I did purchase a laptop from Best Buy for the second channel, and so the monthly payment I am taking from that account as well. And then I do roll over whatever is remaining because I can't be guaranteed of YouTube income on a monthly basis. You do have to make a $100 threshold. And so on the months that I don't, I keep a rollover just so that I can make sure that I have enough money to take care of the Canva.com, the Intuit, and the Best Buy credit card payment. All right, guys, that was a lot of information in a very short amount of time. Now, if you're interested in more videos, from my perspective as a small YouTuber in a very niched market, then definitely leave me a comment below. If you're interested in any kind of this content creator type of video and some things that you'd like to see, definitely leave a comment below just so I can gauge the interest on this. It is something that I wanted to share. And going forward, I don't know that every video where I talk about my YouTube or side project income will be this detailed, but I'm hoping that at least it gives you a perspective of someone who has a very small channel in a very niched market on what my current earning potential is. Alright guys, well, that's it for me for now. And as always, aloha.